Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's topic is about IBKR. So it's a interactive brokers is a way you can buy and sell stocks, options, or other financial instruments. Okay, so today I'll be sharing on why I'm going to stop using IBKR margin account. Okay, so let's go. Okay, so I have been investing using IBKR since 2020, and then what I did, I put in SGD 20k and I didn't put in any USD. Okay, so since I was on like a margin account, I assume like the margin rate should be quite okay one, right? But well, I found out this was not so because I was always investing in the US market and then I didn't convert my SGD to USD at all. So whatever trades I make in USD, you will always be charged based on the margin rates lah. So these are the interest that I incurred over the past just solely based on 2022. Okay, so since I've been investing since 2020, right, you can just imagine how much interest I've been charged. So based on this 11 months interest, I've already incurred SGD $621 in interest. Okay, so that's probably the reason why my investments weren't even making money lah. So because there's so much interest charged to me already. So if you times 3 years, it's like 1,008 pay interest really. Yeah, so this is why I think IBKR shouldn't be, I shouldn't continue using the IBKR margin method anymore, because all these interest will erode my investment gains. So you must be thinking like, how much did I actually invest to incur so much interest rate, right? But actually the fact is the interest rate is damn insane. You can kind of see the rates here. So for USD currency, if you take the margin, right, so obviously I invest between 0 to 100k lah. So the margin rates I'm charged at is 6.33. So that's why I've been charged so much interest over the years. So that being said, it can actually be my own fault lah, because I didn't convert the SGD to USD before actually using it to trade in USD. But there are always many other alternative brokers out there which I will be switching to as well. So Webull is going to be one of the brokers that I'm going to switch to. Okay, so Webull, this is their financing interest rate. So as long as you don't incur more than 50k USD, right, the interest rate is actually 0%. And then if let's say you use more than 50k, the interest rate is only 3.5%. This is so much lower than IBKR's interest rate. Okay, so I'll be switching to Webull for now. And do take note that this interest rate currently is valid till updated lah. So as and when you need to come in and check whether they are starting to charge interest rate. So I mean, if you're holding for like long-term investment, right, definitely you shouldn't be using margin too much. And then if you are trying to use margin, then you need to find a broker that doesn't charge much interest on margin rates lah, if you are using it for investments. If you are using it for trading, then probably 1 or 2 days won't make much of a difference depending. But I believe with quite high interest rate using the IBKR, 6.33 is still going to make a difference. So yeah, please check with your brokers what's the margin rate that's charged. And then please always check your statements. I have not been checking my statements since I started trading, so that's why I was charged all these charges and I didn't even know about it. Another thing about the other than interest rate you should take note of is their commission when they do the currency exchange. So every transaction that you do, they will charge a commission, and usually it's a fixed fee. So previously I was trying to zeroize my balance in the USD not to be negative, right? So I was keep trying to do a small small transaction at a time to zeroize the negative balance in USD. But then I was as I was depleting my SGD, right, like in small amounts, then the amount of USD that was negative didn't change at all. I didn't realize that there was a commission charge per transaction, and then it made it seem that there was no change in my negative SGD, negative USD as well. So do take notes of all this commission charge, and then make sure you do a big transaction at a time so that you don't get charged so much in commission when you are doing a currency exchange. Whereas if you are using Webull, you just get a lousier exchange rate, but they don't charge any fees for that. So depending on which is more suitable for you, you can see there's no fees for doing currency exchange. So even if you do a small amount of exchange, it's just at a lousier rate, there's no fees charged by them. Okay, that's all for today. It's just a short comparison between the current broker I was using was IBKR, and then now I'm using Webull, and I found all these charges that were charged and I didn't know about it. Okay, but that being said, this is all my own fault because they put it out there that all these charges. It's just I didn't realize that I was being charged all these charges. So yeah, I'll be making the change soon. So depends on your need. So if you are really very very big trader, you trade in very big amounts, right? Then maybe a small fee per transaction will make sense for you. Whereas if you're trying to do like small trades or this, right, then definitely sometimes no fees is better lah. So depending on what you want for your trades or your other transactions, so you can determine it for yourself. Okay, so if you have learned something new from this video, please help to like and subscribe. Thank you everyone, bye.